Hello my dear students, welcome to my class. Today I will be discussing chapter number 2 and the name of the chapter is Allah is ever living. Allah is ever living. So ever living, what do you mean by the word ever living? Ever living means immortal, continual and eternal, which doesn't have any end. Okay, so Allah is ever living and Allah is present everywhere. Allah is the creator of this universe. Okay, so He created each and everything in this universe. The universe itself is created by Allah. Allah is ever living and He never sleeps. So as we sleep, Allah never sleeps. Okay, so Allah was never born and Allah always was, He always will be. So as I told you, Allah created this universe. Okay, so Allah was never born, he never dies. Okay, He is continual. The chapter itself tells that ever living, that is immortal, continual, eternal. Okay, so he didn't get any birth. Okay, He never gives birth, he was never born, He was there, He is present and He will be always there. Okay, He is in the past, He is in the present and He will be there. So everywhere Allah. Okay, so Allah has no children, Allah has no son, Allah has no daughters, He has no wife, He is all alone. As we all human beings, not only human beings, all animals on this earth, all the living beings on this earth have their own children, have their own daughter, have their own partner, have their own wife. So Allah doesn't have all these things. Okay, so Allah doesn't have wife, Allah don't have His daughter, His son, He never sleeps, He never eats. Okay, He is alone, He is Allah, the one and only Allah, who created all, who created this universe and all the things which are present in this universe. He alone has full knowledge of everything. Okay, so He is the only one who knows everything. Without His permission, nothing happens in this universe. So with His order, with His permission only, everything happens in this universe. Not even a single leaf falls from the tree without His permission. But He knows everything. Okay, so if the leaf wanted to fall from that tree, that also with the permission of Allah it falls. He knows the leaf is going to fall now at this time. He knows the past, He knows the present, He knows the future. So we don't know, we human beings don't know what will happen in our future, but Allah knows. Okay, so Allah knows everything, what is going to be in future, how will be the future of others. Okay, what is your present, what was your past, everything He knows. Okay, He, with His permission only, everything is happening in this universe. So the universe itself is created by one and only Allah. So you think how much powerful He is. He never sleeps. Okay, he never eats. He knows all that lies open before men, He knows all that is hidden from men. Allah is all watching, so He also knows the hidden things, what is inside your mind. Can you tell what is inside my mind? No, not, nobody can tell in this universe what is inside my mind, what I am thinking now. Nobody can tell that, but Allah knows what I am thinking, what I am doing. Okay, so what I am thinking, everything, what is inside my heart, what is inside my mind, everything He knows. Okay, with His permission only everything is happening. So he can tell, nothing is hidden from him. As you students, okay, hide from your parents, you can tell lies to your parents, you can tell lies to your teachers, you can tell lies to your classmates, you can tell lies to your friends, okay, but not with Allah. So Allah knows, you cannot hide anything from Allah. You can hide anything from anybody, but not from Allah. He is watching, okay? He is watching you. Whatever you are doing, whatever you are not doing, what is inside, what you are thinking to do, everything He knows and He is watching you. Nothing can be hidden from Him because everything is happening with His permission only. So Allah knows all that we bring into the open. In fact, everything is in His sight. He has most handsome names and they are 99. Yes, Allah has the most handsome names. Not 1, 2, 3. He have 99 names. That also the most beautiful and the most handsome names. Okay. So one or two names I'll tell. So Ar-Rahman is the name of another name of Allah. The meaning of Ar-Rahman is the most or entirely merciful. The another name of Allah is Ar-Rahim, the bestower. The meaning of Ar-Rahim is the bestower of mercy. The another name is Al-Malik, so the king and the owner of dominion. So the meaning of Al-Malik is the king and the owner of the dominion. So Al-Quddus, the absolutely pure. Al-Quddus means absolutely pure. So these are some names which I told you, but there are not only 4 or 5 names, there are many names, that is 99 names. That also the names are most beautiful and have the beautiful meanings also. Okay, Allah is the creator, maker and shaper. His are the finest names. So everything in heaven and earth declares His praises. He is powerful. He is the wise. As He created this universe, you know how much power He have in His. He knows your hidden things, whatever you are hiding inside your mind, whatever you are hiding from the others, that also He knows. The leaf doesn't fall from the tree, okay, without His permission. You think the world, the universe is created by the Allah, so you think how much powerful He is. Okay, so all things praises Him in the heaven and in the earth. On the earth declares praises, okay, praises Him. So Allah is wise. Allah is near to us. He takes care of us. We all belong to Him. So we all the children of Allah, okay, who He takes care of us like our parents do, okay. So Allah has no end. He gives life, He gives death. Okay, so Allah is ever living. That means Allah has no end. The chapter itself tells you that Allah is ever living. That means Allah has no end. He is continual. He gives life and He gives death also. He does everything alone and He doesn't take the help of anybody. Like suppose I am not able to do one work, okay, I ask a help from my friend, I ask a help from my colleagues, okay. So Allah never takes help. He is alone. Whatever He do, He does by Himself, okay. So and nothing is hidden from Allah and He knows everything. So a true Muslim believes in Allah and all His powers. A true Muslim should believe in Allah and all His powers. So here ends the discussion. So if you have any questions, any doubts regarding your chapter, with the help of your parents, write it on the comment box. I will clarify it. Thank you.